In 1998, a crack TV cooking show was cancelled for a crime they didn't commit. The chef promptly escaped from a maximum security stockade to the Nottingham City Underground. Today, still wanted by the government, they survive as cooks of fortune. If you have a set of ingredients, if no one else can help, and if you can find them, maybe you can hire the K-Team.
To another fab episode of Cooking with Mr. K. You will notice, after my rant last week, have a look at this. All right, so Ian, Anise, fabulous. I would have preferred it, listen to this, Ian, if it was Leeds, but I'm wearing it just for you, so thank you very much. Okay, also, guys, I'd like to give a shout out to a couple of students who have done really, really, really well with their coursework in food recently. Okay, so Imogen, Bavarelli, 100% in her quiz. Well done. A prize is on its way to you. And then we've got Emily Burton, Nigel Denham, Safa Jabran, Katie Humphrey, Caden Howitt. You came in a very, very close seconds, but well done. There's also a prize on the way to you guys. So very, very well done. Keep it going. We're very, very impressed. Well done. All right. Okay. So here we go then. Cooking with Mr. K. As usual, if you've been watching, guys, you know that I've got a very special sous chef on every week. And here she is, our very own resident dinosaur, Mrs. Yeah! Stewart! What is that? I thought you were keen to be here today.
I am, yeah, I am.
Oh, I don't know. Right, this is going to be very trying today. I can see it coming. Right, okay then. So have you watched the thing before?
Yes.
Right, okay then. So you know, what's the first thing we do?
Get the food out. Is that quicker just to do that? Oh!
Right, okay, what have we got here?
Well, don't do them, because you do them every week and I don't like them, I can't eat them.
Right, okay, so forget those and we'll not bother doing them. What about...
Because I'm fussy, you know I am, and I'm gluten-free. What about you make one of them eggy things, them frittata things, whatever they're called, where you put potato, onion, pepper, cheese, and a bit of chicken. Oh, and eggs. You have to put eggs in, don't you?
You have to put eggs in.
We do.
Yeah, sounds like a plan. Right, okay, can you remember how to dice these two? Right, okay then. So I think what we're going to do then, you're going to have to use your little dinosaur claws. I'll even allow you to use my big chopper, all right?
Okay,
and I'm going to leave you to crack on with that whilst I do my potatoes and potato.
Okay.
Right, just please be careful with that knife.
Right, yeah.
All right, okay, so just anything you're not sure about, just ask.
Do you want me to chop it a certain way? Because I don't do this sort of thing at home.
Yeah. Okay, brilliant.
Cheers.
And then what I'm going to do, look, we've got my peeler. I'm just literally going to peel my potatoes because obviously in the frittata, the eggs cook fairly quickly. So what I'm not wanting to do, I don't want to, put this in raw because obviously it won't have time to cook through quickly. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to par cook these, all right, and then cool them down a little bit. And then I'll cut them up into smaller bits and then we can use them straight into our frittata because I've just essentially just warming them through. And I think I'll just use two potatoes here because obviously our pan is not huge.
Does it matter how small these are?
No, if you can possibly try and get them all the same size. Any ideas why we might do that? All the same size? Any ideas why
we might... So it looks nice?
Well, yeah, it will look nice, but there's one other really,
really
good...
Oh, so they all cook at the same time.
Exactly. Well done.
Right. Mine do vary in size, I'm afraid.
Oh, don't worry. Don't worry. I'll work with whatever your little dinosaur claws do. Right, okay, then, so here we go, then. Let's just get rid of all these little bits and bobs. We don't want all this into my little resident Saturday kitchen bin. Right, okay, so, obviously... If I'm going to cook that, it's going to take like forever. So what I'm going to do, look, is I'm going to get my knife here, and I'm just going to cut them up into, smaller chunks. All right, and for the same reason that Mrs. Fuchs is, cutting those to a similar size, I'm going to do exactly the same with this, so we all cook at the same time, because I don't want to spend forever waiting for these to cook.
Should we count how many times you say in this?
No, we won't. Can't help it. Stop my bolt.
Do you know this one?
Yep.
You've done that and that. Am I now doing that?
Yep, just all the way through, yep, dead easy. Here we go, I think I might just get this one in. There we are, and on with the old lid. And they should take about 15 minutes. All right, how are we getting in there? Right, brilliant, okay. So what I've got here then, this week, look, we've got our little butter pack. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to put this on. And I think I'm going to add some butter. And I'm going to also add some oil. All right, and the reason I'm doing that is we've got butter for flavour and then oil for cooking. Where's my little thingy here?
Oh, sorry, I just used that to scrape the onion off.
Oh, don't worry. Right, okay, so here we go then. So, 4 eggs in there for me, please. There we go, you can do that.
With eggshell or without?
Without, preferably. Right, I presume we know what these are.
Salt and pepper.
And pepper. Okay, so eggs in there, salt and pepper. All right, give them a really, really good mix up. I've just put one in there for you already.
Yeah, but I have to crack it open.
Can't you do it on here like this?
No.
Why not? What's wrong with that?
I do it this way. Oh,
I don't get paid enough for this. Right, here we go then. So we've got that. Right, whilst you're doing that, then do you mind if I just
do you want all these eggs in?
What did I say earlier on? How many eggs did I say I was going to use?
I don't know, sorry.
Four. So we just need to use four. Right, could you possibly pass me those things there. Peppers and onions.
There you go.
Peppers and onions. Here we go. So what I'm going to do, pop these in here. I don't think I'm going to use all of these because
I don't like salt.
Right, okay then. So, as I was saying last week as well, look. With these, look, I don't want to burn them, so I'm just going to cook them very, very slowly. Soften, not burn. So soften, not burn. Normally, I would add some garlic in there, but obviously, you don't really like garlic as much, do you? Which is probably just as well, because I haven't got any.
I do like garlic, I just don't like salt.
Oh, right, okay, just don't like salt. Oh, okay, so very, very slowly, give that 5 or 6 minutes. What we're looking for there is any idea? What we're looking for to happen here?
It's cook.
Yeah, to cook. How?
What?
All right, so we're just looking for them to.
It'll go soggy.
Soggy.
Soggy? Soft.
Soft.
Okay.
Look, we're just looking for it to go soft. Not a lot of colour on there, right? So that's probably going to take about 5 minutes or so. Right, our potatoes are boiling there quite nicely. They're fairly chunky monkey, so they'll probably take about 15 minutes. And then we just need to cool those. And then any ideas what we're going to do after that?
Not a clue.
Right, okay then. So what we're going to do then, you in a minute are going to add half of the cheese to that. Give it a good stir. Then what we're going to do, we're going to put that on into the pan. We're going to cook it for a few minutes. Just to set the bottom. Then we're going to add our onions. We're going to add our peppers. And I'm going to add some of our chicken. And we're going to cook that up in a minute. And then what we're going to do, finish it off with the cheese on the top. Still. I'm just going to cut these potatoes up. All right, okay, so what I would like you to do then, if you don't mind, whilst you're there, if you could put half of that into there, stir it in, and then if you could cut those open and then cut these up into a nice little dice. Doesn't matter if they're really, really small. Not been watching my videos. I'm very.
I have, but I like the comical side of it.
Oh dear.
I'm not really interested in the cooking, I'm afraid.
Oh dear. I don't know.
I am interested in it, but I just don't really want to. I don't cook, so it don't matter.
Right. Okay. So here we go then. So just like you would do, like an omelette. All right. Okay. So I'm just going to let this cook at the bottom here. I'm moving it around because I don't particularly want it to stick. So then what I'm going to do as it starts to congeal sort of thing, I am going to stop it, dinosaur.
Why do you keep calling me dinosaur?
Because you've got little arms. Everyone knows that.
Rude.
Right. Okay. There we go. So that one's looking quite nice. We're just going to give that a few more minutes. Right. How do you think we're going to put the potatoes in there?
Just going to drop them in, aren't you? No, you're going to lay them
Thank
over the
you.
Top.
Just remember, I am an artist.
Are you?
I am, yeah. All right, okay, so.
I thought you was a cook.
Well, cooks are artists, you know. Goodness me.
No, chefs are artists, aren't they? Plate it up all pretty. Okay.
I don't get paid enough for this. Right, okay, there we go. Look, so you start, look, it's starting to cook there, look, starting to coagulate. All right, okay, so what I'm going to do now, whilst that is going on, I think I'm going to add some of my potatoes.
Would it help if you put it over the heat better?
Sorry? It is over the heat.
It's only over half.
Is that better for you?
Yeah.
Good grief.
But it's even on the thing then, isn't it?
Is it? That's nice, isn't it? All right, here we go. Look. So you can
I
use...
I like plenty of potato.
I thought you might. All right, you can use as many potatoes as you like. I mean, notice that we've used our thingies there, haven't we?
So they're called peppers and onions.
Yeah, we've got our peppers and our onions. If you've got anything else in the fridge, you can use tomatoes. What else could you put in there? Tomatoes. You could put
peas.
Peas, sweet corn,
green beans.
I suppose you could put green.
Could
beans
you put broccoli in it?
Yeah, you could put broccoli in there. You just have to do the same we do with the potatoes.
It's very
just
beige,
Just make sure you cut them beforehand. All right, okay, so now I'm going to pop these on here, look, and I'm going to spread these around like this. Mm. Right, and before I pop this, right, under the grill, because I'm only cooking the top once I put it under the grill, all right, so I need to make sure that this bottom, right, is cooked first. Because otherwise, what do you think is going to happen when I turn it out onto my plate?
It's just going to be slop everywhere.
It's going to be sloppy. Right, okay, so I'm quite happy with that now then. We need to pop it under the grill now. Remember, we're going to keep our handle out here because we're going to get a little bit hot. Okay, and what are we looking for?
The cheese starts to go.
Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait. The cheese has started to go!
Right, okay, and here we go. Oh, look at that bad boy. Doesn't that look fabulous?
Yeah, it does, but I can't eat that because it's pre-grated cheese and it has flour on.
What do you mean you can't eat it?
I'm celiac, so I can't eat gluten. So it had flour on the cheese, on pre-grated cheese. If you buy pre-grated cheese, it has flour on.
Oh, no, I've just had a thought, actually. What? We've grated this cheese from a block.
Oh, I can eat it then.
Oh, well, there you go then.
If you haven't put flour on it, cool.
Of course I haven't put flour on it. Why would I do that?
It was in a bag. I thought you'd
Right, okay then. So, shall we give it a go?
Yeah,
are we ready? Are we
yeah.
ready? Are we ready? Are we ready? Yay!
Cool.
Look at that bad boy.
Right.
Here we go then. So, this is the part which most my sous chefs really, really, really like.
Yeah, I'm looking
forward
to it. If
they get to try the food. And here we go, look. Now, just be careful. This is going to be really, really, really hot. So, obviously, you've only got little hands, so I won't give you that
piece. I'm not having that piece.
Sorry? You want that piece?
Yeah. Oh. It looks more well done. And it's got a massive potato sticking out.
Give me strength.
Now, just go for it.
You can go for it. Would you like to use a knife as well, though?
No, it's fine.
Go on, if you get your dinosaur claws in there, you'd be well away.
Shut up about my dinosaur claws.
What do you think of that then? Is that up to
your
standards?
Mm, yeah,
have I done a good job?
Good, can I finish that off?
Of course you can.
Thank you.
Hope you've enjoyed this episode of Cooking with Mr. K. Don't forget now, this is the first one. I've got another one for next week, okay? But I still need write your designs. But please, no more Liverpool, no more Manchester United. I'm a Leeds supporter. Anything with Leeds, you're on the top of the list. Thanks, guys. Hope you've enjoyed it. Please try this at home. See you next week.
Why not have a go at making a meal yourself using these same ingredients? Email any photographs in for Meal of the Week next week. Or why not design a brand new chef hat for Mr. K to be made by Mrs. Owen? Email in your designs to funkychefhat@elliskilfordschool.org.uk.